إن الشيطان لكم عدو فاتخذوه عدوا إنما يدعو حزبه ليكونوا من أصحاب السعير. Indeed, the devil is your enemy. Iblis is your enemy. So consider him an enemy. Look out for him. Watch out. He's an enemy. He has promised he's going to deviate you. So look out. Imagine if someone said, look, there's a thief on the prowl around here. What will you do? You lock your gates. You make sure you tell your children. You tell the whole family, watch out for this car. This is the number plate. I saw it on the group. And you know what? There are people who are prowling. They're kidnapping. They're doing this. They're doing that. You will be very, very careful and alert because you know you don't want any harm. Allah is telling you the same about Shaitan. Watch out. He's on the loose. Subhanallah, we are lucky in Ramadan, he's actually tied up. But the problem and the difficulty is he works so hard pre-Ramadan that the effect of what he wants lasts sometimes through the month. You see it. People swear and shout in the month of Ramadan, impatient. And then they ask, Sheikh, but aren't the devils tied up? So I always say, the devils are tied up, but now you the devil. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. Sometimes it's ourselves. We become shayateen on our own because we've become accustomed to that type of a life where we become arrogant. So the shayateen are gone. Who is left? Well, me and you are left. Someone around here is a devil. Astaghfirullah. May that not be the case. With a believer, we should soften the heart. Soften. As soon as you want to, you know, say something and you know it's wrong and hurtful, calm yourself down. That extinguishing of your anger and temper will actually earn you Jannatul Firdaus. I promise you. So remember, it's a great act of worship to extinguish your anger. Very big act of worship. So Allah says, Shaitan is your enemy. Consider him your enemy. Be on the lookout for him so that you can save yourself from his trap. Look out, how did Shaitan come to me today? He's encouraging me to do this, but it's Ramadan. And even out of Ramadan, I'm not supposed to be doing it. He's trying to trap me to think bad of my brother, my sister. He's trying to trap me to justify the evil that I've perpetrated, etc. Let me never be entrapped by the devil so that we can save ourselves, my beloved brothers and sisters. And this is why Allah says, Shaitan calls his people to the punishment of hellfire. And he knows that he's doing that, but it's a trap. You know, when you have an enemy, he wants to see your downfall. He will give you advice whereby you will destroy relations with your own brothers and he will be happy. Yeah, look what I did. I broke the family. He will give you advice so that your business can go down. Imagine you go to your rival and you say, hey, look, I got a crisis. My business, you know, I'm not making a profit on this. He'll say, no, come. I'll give you advice. You are asking the devil for advice. He is your competition. He'll tell you to do things such that within 1 month, you suffer a bigger loss. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never let that happen to us.